YouTube. B. Higgles here. We are up in Lynnville, Indiana. And this is one of my favorite private lakes that I have permission for. And this thing is loaded with the big bass. This lake is the reason I switched to 65 pound braid, because I have lost some serious fish here before on mono, and that's not going to happen anymore. So we're of course in the Nucanoe kayak. Gonna get out there and see what we can catch. Stay tuned, more coming up. All right, it's a super nice cloudy day. Ought to be some action today. Speaking of action, Action Jackson might be joining us later. Let's hope he gets out here. I do apologize for the breeziness. It is a little breezy, but some monster bass in this lake. Pretty clear today. Usually it's kind of murky. Gets fed by a stream that a lot of rain runoff, so I like it when it's murky. You can use a crankbait. I like the red crawdad crankbait. It does really, really well here when it's murky. Of course, as usual, I'm running this black and blue tri-blade. We'll try it first. No love. We'll put on a white clacker. Makes a little bit more noise. And see if we can get one to rise up. If not, we'll try some crankbaits and some dingers. And just all sorts of good stuff. Get a first fish right here real quick, get some action early. In fact, I may tie on a crankbait for here today. Do have the dinger tied on at the moment. Fish in Lynnville. There is a place called Lynnville Lakes, open to the public. It's only like $3 to fish. It's a really, really big lake. I have been several times. prefer private. It gets a lot less pressure. I think I'm gonna tie on a crankbait actually. All right, we're back. Hope you got a sandwich. This is the X Mark crankbait. Your standard colors. Standard whites. It is a bit of a suspender. It does rise, but slowly. We got a woodpecker over there. Sounds like a plated. Like I said, normally if it was murky, I'd throw my little crawdad colored red crankbait. That thing, whew. They sure do like it here. Maybe red's the color today, even with the water not being murky. We'll find out. Warm up. Can't hardly get myself to untie the buzz bait. It's just so productive. Meanwhile, you're saying you're not catching any fish, Higgles. So how's that productive? Well, I just know over the years, push comes to shove, the old Strike King tri-blade is a money bait. Hey, not even up there in the shade, huh? I mean, right by the stumps and the limbs and the nothing. X mark. See if the X marks a spot. He's just a wee dinker. First fish, though. That only took, I don't know, 20, 30 minutes. Ahead of us there where that stump is in the water. Yeah, you're like which stump? That stump. Anyway, I know over here there's a big ridge. It's really flat past that stump and then it drops off. We got something here, ladies and gentlemen. Oh yeah. Oh, here we go. Now we're talking. Oh, yeah. Right on that. And that's it. That's a better fish right there. Yes, sir. Hello, Mr. Bass. How are you doing? Maybe there's some others hanging out there. Usually when you find one bass, there will be more around them. They like to run in schools. Feel that X mark just binging against the bottom. Dig, 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 dig. Which is good. Oh, missed another one. Dang it. There we go. There's another one. This feels much better. Oh, no. He's not too bad. Come on in here, buddy. Yeah. Come on up here. Let me talk to you. That is for three in a matter of minutes. So I think we are on to a pattern. Like everything else in life, fish respond to cycles. When you find a pattern that's working, stick with it. So far, that pattern seems to be coming off the shallow, super shallow, dropping down that ledge with the crankbait. Oh, missed another. Dang it. Against the bottom, I can feel that. Doop, 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 doop. Doop. when it does that, that blade digs down in the mud down below and stirs the mud up, and it kind of looks like a crayfish or something. Very productive. Sometimes I pause, sometimes I don't. Just depends on what's happening. Boom, feel it bumping that bottom again, yes. Oh, had another bite. So we're on to a good pattern, that's for sure. YouTube, we got the, I think it's the 110 whopper plopper, that kind of yellow one. Sound it makes. Did switch out to the white clacker for top water. I don't know, I just don't catch much on them whopper ploppers. Said probably because I only gave it 5 minutes, but check out this black crappie on Xmark. Look how black he is. Wow. Pretty cool.
Two species.
Hey YouTube, Biggie B Higgles here again. We got another black crappie. Check him out. Looks like a sharpie. Wow. He is dark. As you can hear in the background, that is Action Jackson joining me this afternoon. We're gonna see if we can catch us some fish.
How y'all doing today? I'm AJ. For your poor country redneck folks like myself, why spend all that money on a kayak anchor? I mean, you gotta rig it, you gotta drill holes in the side of your, I mean, who wants to do that? What do you do? Go to your backyard. I know every redneck around here has an aluminum four-wheeler rim. Lightweight. Get that rope that you're going to put on your son's swing. No, sir. Put it on the rim. When you want to just throw it out. Look at that. Easy. Out. No fuss. No muss. And when you want to pick it up, look there. It's so lightweight. Look at how easy that is. No fuss. No muss again. Look at that. No weeds. No mess. That's how you do it right there.
And that's the Action Jackson anchor. Hi YouTube, B Higgles here. I do apologize, but my cell phone battery is dying and I did not bring an external today. So we'll have to cut the evening short, but if I get anything exciting, we'll take some pictures and I'll have them on there. I appreciate everybody coming out. Enjoy you being with me and I hope you had a good time and I'll see you next time. This is B Higgles. Peace out. Thank you.